Can you tell me in a short time the history of diplomacy of the Lithuania and the origin of this exhibition?
Of course, the modern Lithuanian diplomacy was born with the creation of Lithuanian modern state, or as we called the rebuilding of the state of Lithuania, from not talking about, yeah, from medieval Grand Duchy of Lithuania, modern state. And in the wartime, from various information bureau raising the Lithuanian question, the Lithuanian nation question, some active people became first Lithuanian envoys, those who were presenting Lithuanian case and the necessity of restoration of Lithuania to the societies in different European capitals and in the United States. So after the country was recognized, Lithuania started to establish Lithuanian embassies, consulates in most important European countries, and in in the United States, of course, because big Lithuanian community lived there together with American Italians in the United States. And later, with some emigration, new wave of emigration to the countries of South America, we created a couple of embassies and consulates in South America countries.
2018, creative diplomacy. It's a short overview what kind of achievements we did.
Very interesting.
I think in English we could use. Gabriel Sparshaitis in 1911 established in Paris Lithuanian Information Bureau for American Lithuanian money to explain, and he started with some even famous French politicians to work about how they called slaver nations or small nations, which are unknown for the big great powers. They act, everybody keeping silence about them. So they start.
Kovno, Vilna, and so on, from German newspapers. Wilhelm Kaiser was twice in Lithuania in the wartime, and so on, Deutsche Theater, and so on, and the Vilna Rasensport Fest, Vilnius Festival in Vilnius. What Lithuanian Latvia expecting from Santa Claus, humor, and so on. So, and Amber Declaration, in when the war started between Russia and
Central States.
And the Central States, Germany, the group of Lithuanian politicians presented so-called Amber Declaration. They said that Lithuania is for the to fight with Russia for the liberation, and all the amber, Lithuanian amber, will be collected in one Lithuania, autonomous Lithuania in Russian Empire. It was allusion in West East Prussia Lithuanians, 100,000, that to connect amber in one. So the pretensions already. So later the declaration was forgotten because it from autonomy purpose, Lithuanian thought was going to independence. Especially the first independence was printed in the March 1916, the leaflet. And it was written clearly that we now will fight for independence.
Yeah, each is famous, our politician. Many Lithuanians lived abroad in Riga, in Latvia, because Lithuania was a cultural country. The towns, cities were not big. So emigration to St. Petersburg, Riga, Odessa, many, and then in the wartime, when the German army was coming, the Russians transferred people to Russia as exiles, just from the front line. They pushed people to go to Russia. So about 300,000 Lithuanians definitely lived in Russia. They start to organize politically in the society of to help for those refugees, and they stop. The gymnasiums were transferred in Voronezh, for example. Three Lithuanian gymnasiums were working in the wartime. By the way, Lazaraitis was the pupil in that gymnasium. So and when they came. When they came back to Lithuania, they became famous. Then Lithuanian Information Bureau in Switzerland. You see, it was necessary to present Lithuania for the world, because Lithuania was somehow known from history. Here is information. Here we have first independence exhibition since 1915, developing, you know, a Lithuanian passport. We created such diplomatic passports, and here you could see the photos related with the time and the Independence Act first government. Creation of foreign ministry, the first people who were working here, diplomatic passports of Lithuania for Valdemaras and Klimas, first ministries building, and so on. And the project of Lithuanian border. Here I suppose to say one thing. After independence, I created such information here, how from commissars which organized Lithuanian transfer to Lithuania, how people were going to the diplomats and how become representatives in various countries. The problem of Lithuania pre-war time was territorial. First of all, between disputes and conflict, even military conflict, we had always the very tough relations with Poland, because Vilnius was historical capital of Poland, but it was Polish city. So they lived at 4% of Lithuanians. So, it was impossible to found a compromise because of Polish politicians cannot transfer to Lithuania Polish city, and we had no strength to regain after Poland seized Vilnius in April 1919. So that was it, so we had always complicated, and we became a revisionistic state of Europe. Always we demanded to change the borders, to return, because Poles created Litva-Šortkova, this Lithuania with Vilnius as a middle of Lithuania. The Polish myth was that there were three historical Lithuanian parts: Kaunas Lithuania, Vilnius Lithuania, and Minsk Lithuania. So Vilnius Lithuania, they organized the elections. No, the Polish army was in. We didn't recognize. And they vote to join Poland. So the ambassador's conference in 1923 recognized Vilnius for Poland. That was it. But in 1923, after events in... this is your famous Vilna Lituania in Italy, our representation. We regained Klaipeda, seaport, and with Lithuanian population in the province.
the city was German, and we have another one territorial problem with Germany later, because Entente took Klaipeda region from Germany and start to administer French. So then we are going to seize the Klaipeda, and Klaipeda was recognized to Lithuania with the rights of autonomy. So in this sense, we didn't ask to change borders. In Vilnius question, we were asking to change the borders. Klaipeda borders supposed to as it is. So could you imagine how difficult it was for Lithuanian diplomacy to fight with two different demands, six gubernias of Russian Empire. But we pretended in three, because new countries like Poland and Lithuania now was on the organization of ethnic principle, with the language, mainly with the language, and territories who are coming. So three princes: Vilnius, Kaunas, Gubernias, Suvalki, and a little part of Grodno. So that's modern. Zoraitis' mother was Polish, and he, in the young years, he was hesitating who is Pole or Lithuanian. But his uncle, Tadas Petkevičius, said, if you are thinking in Lithuanian, you are Lithuanian. And if you're planning to live in Lithuania, you are Lithuanian. So Lozoraitis became Lithuanian. His cousins, Mackevich family, both Mackeviches from Vilna, it was famous people and writers in the Polish movement. And Lozoraitis was, he knew what Poles are thinking. He had contacts, private. And in 1934, because it was very tense, we had no diplomatic relations with Poland since 1920. And this was nonsense. No trains, no highway was, because Vilnius we already lost. And then to start to fight for Klaipeda. But unfortunately, President and Prime Minister didn't agree with that, Lozoraitis, because we needed a clue. And the Polish Foreign Minister, Józef Beck, was very tough. Of Lithuanian diplomatic service abroad. Here the Soviet time, Voldemaras died from the hunger in Moscow, in the jail. All ministers, diplomats were arrested. Bishop Reynis and others, they died, or in the Bizauskas was shot in Cherven near Minsk, a political prisoner, Bishop Reynis. Daukantas and Urbšys were sentenced, Klimas sentenced. So here is chronicle of Soviet time. It's moved to the West, they created a Soviet bloc, and we became a part of Soviet Union as a Soviet Republic, Soviet Socialist Republic. No sort of a cultural autonomy was. Schools in Lithuanian, in the university you learn in Lithuanian, but that's in some, but police, army was in Russian, everything. No national units. Land reform, they created kolkhozes from the private land, farmers were connected into collective farms.